raise me up so I can't stand on mountains.
Praise the Lord. Again, greetings to the Word Explained broadcast. And again, it's coming to you under the auspices of the Mason Hall Pentecostal Church. And it's so nice to be in your homes, maybe on your mobile devices, or wherever this program is reaching you. And those of you on the World Wide Web, we are so glad that you have joined in with us today. My scripture is taken from the Gospels, and in particular, the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 5, or verses 25 following. It's a pretty lengthy reading, but I think for the purpose of understanding, it must be read. The word says, "And a certain woman, which had an issue of blood 12 years, and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had, and nothing better, but rather grew worse. And when she heard Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but the hem of his clothes, I will be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood dried up. And she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing that in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned about in the press and said, who touched me? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and sayest thou, who touched thee? And he looked about, round about, to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him, and told him all the truth. And he said unto her, daughter, thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace, and be whole of thy plague." Today, I just want to chat with you a little bit on the thought, what is your issue? What is your issue? It is critical for us to understand the text before us, as prayer has already been made. But the word is saying to us here that a certain woman had an issue of blood for 12 long years. Now, what is critical for us to understand here, it is important that we get a picture of the meaning of the word issue. Hence the reason, the thought today, what is your issue? What is your issue? I'm saying this against the backdrop, my friends, because the Bible tells us that this certain woman had an issue of blood. Now, I was looking at the word issue, and it means that which flows out of, that which is distributed, or there are another definition. There are about 20 odd definitions to define the word issue, that which comes out of. So if we have to use this definition, that which flows out of, as in this woman's case, what is clear here, the Bible tells us that the blood, she had an issue of blood. That means blood was flowing out of her, amen, for 12 long years. No, the Bible did not tell us how old she was at the time when this particular problem arose. But then it caused me to think and the Bible tells us the things that she endured because of this particular thing, this particular thing that was coming out of her, that is the blood. And as we are told, amen, in earlier scriptures, that the life is in the blood. So in essence, what this woman was really experiencing, she was experiencing a slow depleting of her life. In other words, she was dying slowly. Hallelujah. And then it caused me to think, how do we correlate this? How do we relate this to life and those of us who are living today? There is, it's not only the miracle, the miraculous that took place there that should be focused on, because I believe in the message itself, in the word itself, there is a message there for all of us, because it is saying is that which flows out of her that was killing her. And may I say, Jesus also made a statement when he talked about there were those who came to Jesus and said, tried to tell him about his disciple. They were eating with unwashed hands. And Jesus said, it's not what goes into a man that defiles the man, but that which comes out of him. So in essence, amen, we can say without a shadow of a doubt that from all of us, there is an issue that flows out of us. It will be seen in our lives. You know, I had the opportunity to witness a debate recently, amen, on one of our network, amen, hallelujah. And they were looking at the whole issue of this American election, and there was this video that showed one of the candidates, and they were saying, that's nothing. If you see the man normally, what he said there is not anything. That is not the person. I wish, amen, I strongly disagree with the fact, amen, for from the abundance of a man's heart, so he speaks. And I'm saying to us, ladies and gentlemen, young and old, whosoever you are today, amen, there is something that comes out of us, amen. And if we are not careful, we got to take note. We got to know what is the thing that is flowing out of us. May I ask, is it, amen, a life of joy? Is it a life of peace? Is it frustration? Is it, amen, should I say depression, or should I say is it weariness? Is it a sense, amen, of disgust? Is it hatred? Is it resentment? Is it bitterness? My friend, there's something that is flowing out of us, every one of us, I must add. And if, amen, that which is flowing out of us is not in tune with God's word and God's way for us, my friends, I am saying to you, just as this woman with the issue of blood, amen, hallelujah, it is slowly depleting our life as God intended it to be. So my friends, the Bible tells us, amen, hallelujah, the first thing about this woman's issue, she recognized that thing that is flowing out of her, amen, has the potential to destroy her, amen, to destroy her life. And the word of God tells us that she sought, amen, help. I am saying to you, my friends, there are those of you, amen, hallelujah, you have a serious problem, amen, hallelujah, with your mouth. There are some who are having serious problem, amen, with vices, that which is flowing out of them, amen. There's a constant impulse in them, amen. There's some people say they are compulsive gamblers, amen, hallelujah. This thing is killing you. It is robbing you, amen, of the best that you can be. Some of you, amen, is the habit, amen, some kind of drinking or smoking or some kind of habit, amen, that is robbing you of your very life. And when you look at those, amen, maybe, hallelujah, your mates, those who you grew with, those who you, amen, about your same age, and you compare them, you're asking yourself the question, what am I doing with my life? And I'm saying to you, sir, you got to pay particular attention. I am saying to you, ma'am, you got to pay particular attention of what's coming out of you as an individual. And may I say, if you are a child of God, hallelujah, what should be coming out of you? Amen. The word of God tells us, hallelujah, is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Because, sir, amen, the kingdom of God is not meat or drink, but the same, hallelujah, righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. So the Bible tells us that this woman, she was faced with a situation. The Bible said that she suffered many things of many physicians. Amen. It would seem to me that the woman, amen, she tried. She had a desire. She recognized. And as I said before, recognition of your problem is very important. The thing for many of us, my friends, is that we have a problem. Amen. Hallelujah. Where we pretend that it's not there. But I'm saying, though it may not, hallelujah, be as the physical blood that flows out, that was flowing out of this woman, I am saying to you, amen, there is, amen, that which is flowing out of you also has the same potential to do the same thing, amen, that the blood, amen, the loss of blood that this woman was experiencing had on her. So I'm saying to you, sir, you need to come, amen, hallelujah, to the recognition that there is a situation that is facing you. Hallelujah. We cannot be naive. Some people, amen, are very, amen, they are very naive about their situation. Amen. Hallelujah. That's nothing. We take it for granted. Hallelujah. But I'll say to you, my friends, what you think is unnecessary or what you think is trivial is that is going to kill you. But this woman recognized, amen, that she's going to do something about it. Some people, like the woman, recognize that they have a problem. And also, they set out to do something about it. But the thing about it is where and who they choose, amen, as the agent, amen, for their transformation. My friends, amen, the woman, the Bible tells us, amen, she saw it, amen, it was a medical problem. And therefore, she went to the medical, amen, professionals, amen, hallelujah, as a means for her, amen, hallelujah, relief. But I'm saying to you, my friends, hallelujah, this woman, she tried the natural means or that which is common, that which is the natural flow of life. But I'm going to let you know, my friends, amen, hallelujah. The Bible tells us that what happened is instead of she grew better, the Bible tells us, and she grew worse, not only so her situation was further compounded by the fact that all her earnings, all that she had, was spent in the process. It was spent in the process. Hallelujah. But the Bible tells us, amen, hallelujah, that the woman, amen, the woman, amen, continued. She continued, amen, to seek an answer to her situation. Now, to some of us, my friends, amen, hallelujah, we have tried, amen, we know that this issue is in our lives. Some again, amen, we have come to the place where, amen, hallelujah, we are naive. But then there are those who recognize, hear what, there is something I can do about this situation. And the Bible tells the woman tried, amen, but her trials or her try or her efforts, amen, prove fruitful. But the word of God also tells us that, hallelujah, she had a desire to ensure that her situation was resolved. And the Bible said, amen, she noted the condition and the condition, the progression of her situation. It seems like this thing began to be expanded or increased. So the Bible tells us here that, amen, when, hallelujah, amen, and was nothing better, on the contrary, but rather grew worse. So where she began, it seemed that it progressed into something much more devastating. In other words, the process, amen, of her losing it all, amen, begin to be accelerated. My friends, I want you to note today, hallelujah, that the woman had this another thing about this woman that we can take a picture from or we can learn from. The Bible tells us, amen, that she did not stop there because she recognized, amen, if I don't get this thing under control, if I don't bring it, amen, under control, I am going to die. And the Bible tells us, my friends, amen, hallelujah. She went about, amen, making inquiry. And a person in this particular condition, amen, hallelujah, I always seek all means, natural. But I want to introduce to you, my friends, as what was introduced to the woman. The Bible says, when she heard of Jesus. Just that statement alone, my friends, amen, in itself is the embryonic stages of the woman's deliverance and the woman's breakthrough. Her issue was now, hallelujah, amen, in the beginning stage of its demise. Amen. Why? Because she heard of Jesus. Now you may say, what is he talking about? I am saying that she heard of Jesus. Knowledge of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Changed the entire, amen. Hallelujah. Her entire way of thinking. The Bible says she heard of Jesus. The next thing the Bible tells us, and she came. The point here, sir, is one thing to hear. Amen. That the issue that I have, glory to God. Amen. There is someone that can deal with it for me and deal with it, may I say, expeditiously and effectively. The Bible tells us that she heard. She heard of Jesus. And the word said, my friends, when she heard of Jesus, hallelujah. I wonder what you are hearing, my friends. I wonder what you are hearing. The Bible tells us she heard of Jesus. I believe she heard of this Jesus. Hallelujah. When there was, amen, the need for food among 5,000, there were 2 loaves, amen, and a few fishes. And the Bible tells us, amen, that he was able to feed that 5,000, my God, hallelujah, with a few loaves and 2 little fishes. I'm saying that the woman, I believe the woman, she heard, amen, of a woman called Mary Magdalene, who out of her came 7 devils. The Bible tells us, I believe she heard, my God, hallelujah, of those at time when they went fishing and they came up with nothing, hallelujah. But the Bible tells us, I believe she heard, amen, hallelujah, that Jesus said, let's go out. And when they went out after, my God, they had a multitude of fish, hallelujah, amen, that the entire village, everybody get blessed. Why? Because, hallelujah, Jesus came on the scene. So she heard of Jesus. And the Bible tells us that knowledge of Jesus, amen, spurred within her, amen, a desire, amen, hallelujah, for the transformation, hallelujah, that she needed. I'm saying to you, sir, what have you heard about Jesus? You've been going through all that you're going through. You're experiencing all these things. You try all kind of things. You went by the father. You went by the mother. You went by the sister. You went by everybody. Amen. You went by somebody. Amen. Whether it's by night or by day, you carry this and you gave the other. And to no avail, your situation remained the same. But I'm saying to you, my friends, today, hear the word of the Lord. Be as this woman, whatever issue that is flowing out of you. As a matter of fact, some people say, what is flowing out of me is a result of what somebody do me, and as a result of that, I am what I am. Oh, hallelujah. But I'm saying to you, no, sir, regardless to what means or how this issue began, hallelujah, it can end, hallelujah, if you hear of Jesus and respond as this woman responded. Glory to God. The Bible tells us, sir, hallelujah, that she heard of Jesus. She heard of Jesus. Hallelujah. What are you hearing, my friends? What are you hearing? I know there are myriads of voices and there are number of statements that are made of a number of things around us, and this will do it and that will do it. Maybe Omega this and the other, and everybody, amen, is advertising and so on. But what have you heard of Jesus? Amen. This Jesus, amen, that so many people have spoken about, my friends. What have you heard of Jesus? I could tell you what I've heard of Jesus. I heard that this Jesus, hallelujah, is a soul-saving Jesus. Hallelujah. When Jesus comes in, the tempter's power is broken. When Jesus comes in, hallelujah, all fears are wiped away. You see, I was riddled with that. Hallelujah. But I want to thank God today. When Jesus comes, hey, hallelujah, he came into my heart to stay. And it's different now since Jesus, amen, saved my soul. I say it's different now, hallelujah, since by his blood I am made whole. I'm saying the same thing to you today. Whatever your issue is, I'm saying to you, my friends, amen, you can experience resolution. You can experience a breakthrough. This thing don't have to kill you morally. It don't have to kill you spiritually, it don't have to kill you behaviorally, it don't have to kill you, amen, you can experience, it don't have to kill or destroy your family, it don't have to destroy your life, sir, it don't have to destroy your good relationship, it don't have to destroy you, amen, you can come to Jesus. She heard of Jesus and she came, hallelujah. Now the other thing about this woman, the Bible said, and she pressed, hallelujah, behind to touch and touch his garment. I want you to know something today. I want you to know something. You got to make a conscious decision that regardless to what comes, hallelujah, your way, you need to understand when you decide, amen, to bring a change to your situation, there will always be challenges. I said there are going to be challenges, but the Bible tells us that this woman, hallelujah, she said, regardless to the challenge, regardless to the obstacle that stand in the way, how about the obstacle of discouragement? How about the obstacle of bad talk? Amen. Somebody say, boy, go down by the place, down by the church, down there. Pastor, I will pray for you in the name of Jesus, for the same yesterday, today, and forever. I'm saying to you, my friends, you need to have an experience, an encounter with Jesus, with that issue you have with gambling. You need to have an encounter with Jesus, with the issue you have, amen, with that alcohol consumption. You need to have, amen, an encounter with Jesus, amen, because of that woman is when I's in problem. Some people have problem, amen, hallelujah. They don't know how to label it. But I'm saying to you, but all you're seeing, you know you had a problem and you can't put, amen, a name to it. Amen, all that you know, when you look at this thing in every facet, what it's doing, it's negatively impacting your life. I'm saying to you today, be as the woman, amen, she came to Jesus and she decided, she was determined to ensure that whatever the situation is, I am going to press in. Ma'am, you might be sitting there, you might be lying on that bed and you're having this problem. I'm saying to you, just as you are, without one plea, that woman came in a condition and she pressed. The Bible says she pressed and she touched his garment, what she said, that means, amen, she demonstrated faith in God. She said, if I could but touch the hem of his clothes, I will, hallelujah, behold, because she understand, glory to God, hallelujah, faith in Jesus will move a mighty mountain. Faith in Jesus will calm a troubled sea. No, her attention was not, or her object was not, hallelujah, to have a face on with Jesus. She just wanted to get a touch. Amen. Now the Bible tells us in the 30th verse that the woman, amen, Jesus, that touch made a difference, because the Bible tells us, amen, her touch was not just a touch. She wanted, amen, to connect. She wants something to flow in. Hear what? So Jesus recognized, he too recognized that an issue went out of him. So he said, hear what? Somebody touch me. Oh, glory to God. Somebody who touched me. Who touched me? Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. This is all something we sing. Oh, hallelujah. When I was praying to Jesus, somebody touched my soul. Hear me today, my friends. Amen. Jesus recognized that he had a touch. Why? Because you see, faith, hallelujah, the woman's faith was in demonstration here. Her faith, amen, hallelujah, hallelujah. Her faith, my friends, that's what, amen, that moved Jesus. The Bible tells us, amen, hallelujah, she touched him. And the Bible said that Jesus said, hallelujah, and Jesus immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him. In this case, virtue issued out of him. Oh, glory to God. Sir, madam, today I draw your attention to this fact, asking you the very question, this question, what is flowing out of you? What is your issue? I'm saying amen, hallelujah, regardless to what it is. I'm saying you can find relief in Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us, amen, that those around him, amen, hallelujah, could not understand the dynamics. They could understand, amen, hallelujah, what transpired, amen. But one thing, it was a conversation, amen, in the realms of the spirit between the woman and Jesus only. Because they that were around, amen, they were there, but yet still they were not, amen, a part of this conversation that was taking place in the spirit. Glory. Hallelujah. I'm saying to you, hallelujah, this is a matter between you and God. The Bible shows here, this was a matter between the woman and Jesus. So she had a desire. Amen. She said in her heart, she came, she heard, she came, and she had an objective in mind. I want to touch him. If I touch, I'm going to, hallelujah, hallelujah. I had a songwriter say, for I have touched the hem of his garment, and his blood has made me whole. Sir, madam, I want you to know today, glory to God, hallelujah, hallelujah, what this woman was seeking really was not just, amen, an encounter with, amen, cloth or material. She wanted, amen, a synchronization between herself, amen. In other words, she poured out herself unto God. I want you to listen to this, my friends. She poured out her soul to God, and he poured himself, glory, into her. Glory to God, the Bible said. And when that particular process, amen, was completed, amen, the thing about it is the sudden nature of such a pouring out and pouring in. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The Bible tells us, amen, hallelujah, that, amen, immediately the fountain, or straightway, the fountain of her blood dried up, hallelujah, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. I like the word plague. So ladies and gentlemen, hear me right now. My time is up, but I want you to remember, you need to ask yourself the question, what is your issue? And the flowing out of the same from your life, what impact it is having and you. God bless you. Remember, this is the Word Made Plain broadcast, the Word Explained broadcast, sorry. You can, amen, tune in, amen, every Friday evening, hear the Word of the Lord, and amen, turn to Jesus. Remember, he makes the difference in whoever he touches. God bless you. Do have a wonderful week in Jesus. Bye-bye.
So I can't stand a mountain.